Hello, Honey Bunches. Welcome back to another video. Lovely to be here again. I'm a little out of practice. Thank you for the lovely comments on the last video. Been doing a lot of reflecting since that video. It's also been very hectic and busy with my microbakery. If you're new, when I refer to microbakery, it's about my vegan and gluten-free microbakery I'm starting in Southeast Melbourne, Wurrung Country, Bayside area, which I'm so close to launching in the next couple of weeks. But true to what I said, I have been sort of like playing around with social media formats, doing a lot of reading, reflection about like, and I think the crux of it is that me and YouTube, we are the most authentic social media experience, but me being on this so long and having grown up on the platform, for me, there's no distance between it. So it feels very kind of exhausting and not as easy breezy and fun. There's also the it's a lot of work part. I don't see what I'm filming or my videos so much through fresh eyes, because it's just such a familiar process, like filming, putting together a video. If I had lived out of home, that would probably help. I think it does help with having like this exciting venture I'm starting. And I do think what a few of you were saying, and that like long form is sort of the future. I think we will all as a society come back around to it. So I will make videos here and there, but yes, I guess not be so rigid in my routine, which has the consequence of killing any joy that comes with updates. There are many. I think in the last video I hadn't found a premise. Your gal has, and as of yesterday I met with the council's food safety health officer person, which wasn't an intimidating experience at all. They earn a heck ton of money, by the way. I did a little research because I didn't really know what to expect. Maybe my most prominent pop culture reference is the one in Friends. But yeah, there's like self-assurance built into the paycheck, but also like what their job is. But it was fine. It's nothing that scary. They want to help you. It's a working relationship. And the result of that was they approved, which they were probably always going to do because I'm not starting like a new business. I'm not building anything afresh. I'm like subletting an existing kitchen, which is registered. But hopefully they will send through the paperwork and the fees that need to be paid today. And then your bae's registered. Heck yes. Honestly, a bit too exhausted to like fully lean into the excitement and a bit daunted by how much there is to do come launch. But yeah, I'm doing good. Like very proud of my ability to persist and like build up my resilience with all the inevitable bumps in the road. It's a very fresh experience. So much jargon, so many things to get your head around, like FPOS machines and point of sale software. I know. And that's coming from someone who's starting so baby small. So I'm continually having the thought to myself that it shouldn't be this hard. Like I'm tertiary educated and English is my first language. And yeah, I'm 24, but like it's a lot to get your head around. At the moment, my tentative launch pop-up date is in 2 weeks. And while it's looking like I might be registered, don't want to jinx it, before then, I really wouldn't mind the extra time. There are certain things that need to arrive in the mail and to finish getting set up, but also marketing and like getting the word out. Even though this kitchen is like the most reasonable of all those I looked at, it's still a considerable deduction from your profit. And then there's ingredients as well. So kind of really hoping people turn up, you know. Yeah, wouldn't mind the extra time to do some wholesome marketing, which has been working really well so far. The Biscuit Tin Bakery sort of account and stuff is on the rise, and my like cake boxes, which I've been doing and trying to sort of put the feelers out and get people who might be interested for whatever reason, vegan, gluten-free, celiac, new bakery spots, people in the area, and finding them in like their different bubbles on social media has really worked. Like when people follow Biscuit Tin Bakery, I like check their account and usually you can see where they are. And it's like, yes, when they're local, because while I've known from like selling cookbooks and stuff that, you know, there is a considerable percentage in Melbourne, you know, being local enough to actually want to come is a whole different story. But let's do a little show and tell. I have lots of things to show you. So my mum came to the rescue yesterday. It's not really complete, but it's essentially an A board or an A frame thing that you might have if this was filled in with extra wood, which my dad will help me with. You know, it's like the kind of thing you have outside the front of a cafe, or in my case, in front of the building that my pop-up will be in. We will put two panels on this and I'll paint it in chalkboard paint, and then I'll have it outside the premise which the pop-up will be in the week before, just so foot traffic can hear about it. And then I'll change it up and like have the menu of what is at the pop-up on the day of. But this was in storage, having been used for a number of like community fetes. and it was built by a local men's shed, which I'm chuffed about. That's exactly what I was after. Because if you look up trying to buy one of these, you get the like the most generic crappy, you know, like fake timber wood looking things. And like, I'm not a woodworking specialist, but I can see that it's not the most difficult of structures. So it's like, I wish I had the skills to just be able to execute this. But yeah, knowing me, I like something to be a bit handmade and just made with practical, skilled, loving hands. So this is awesome. My business cards arrived in the mail this week. I bought them from No Issue, which you might have heard of. They're pretty leading for many reasons in the merch business sort of accessory space. I'm honestly very happy because they pointed me in the direction of like making this look a bit swisher, and I'm glad they continually nudged me and there was no like limit to how many proofs they could do. It was like 8 in the end, so they were patient. I just got a simple sort of collage design of the tins on the front, and then cute little info and story time and deets on the bottom. And then for customizing packaging, I got a stamp which says Biscuit Tin Bakery. I smudged it a bit, so this isn't the best example, but that's what it looks like. I won't be making this what my packaging looks like. I just had it and thought I'd test it out. Hopefully that'll last me a very long time. The kitchen I'm using is so decked out with equipment and utensils and stuff, but one thing I did realize I don't have a lot of are cooling racks, so got some professionally sized ones, but honestly might use these at home in the meantime because they're really finely meshed. A lot of mine are like an inch square, and if you're making small cakes, especially like moist ones, they can like sink, you know, down into it. That's not what you want. I'm very ready for seeing these like covered with goods, you know. A little scared upping my quantities that much, but that'll be so cool. This week has dragged on. As kind of bizarre as Australia's day of mourning public holiday for the Queen is next Thursday, it means we get a 4-day long weekend, and that can't come soon enough. I'm gonna try and decide on packaging and try and find some good airtight tubs to hold my ingredients in at the kitchen. I confirmed with the council health safety that yeah, I can have like a huge tub that is airtight and then put the bags of things that are semi-used inside it, because if you have a container for all of it, A, that's like easier to like put all in one lid, but it gets super expensive as well if you're having like a fleet of airtight containers. Really daunting. They're expensive. When in the scheme of things at this stage, I won't have that much. So that's great. I'm also gonna do a quote for a catering job. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna tell you. I made a hard decision this week, which I knew in my gut I needed to concede to. And that is, okay, it feels kind of stupid thinking that I thought that I could achieve this, but I have a very clear, very exciting cookbook in mind that I'd hope to do from here till mid-November and release in time for Christmas. And it kind of has to be released in time for the holidays because it is a cookbook centered around food you'd want to share. So that needs to be the timing. And then it's like, if I don't do it now, then such a long way till the next opportunity. However, the years get shorter and Phoebe, like, you're starting a business. Maybe it's not the best time to try and do. It's also quite an ambitious cookbook. Not so much recipes. I think that'd be very, what's the right word? Like, there wouldn't be too many surprises because I have all these new techniques ready to share in like a collection of recipes, but it's the photography, and it doesn't mean I have to go anywhere crazy, but yeah, it's a little specific. So I think I'm going to shelve that idea for next year, but it might mean I can be a bit of a bad boss business bitch and actually start it earlier in the year. You know, I'm not, and that way there'd be less of a stress in getting it printed and shipped off to you if you wanted it as a Christmas present or something. So I guess my plan from here to the end of the year is Biscuit Tin Bakery, and I think that's healthier because I am using this as sort of a trial period to like see how it goes. As someone who doesn't love making plans way, way into the future, that's how I'm framing it in my mind. And that way I kind of go all in within healthy like parameters. And I was thinking, and because doing this is kind of giving me a lot of confidence just in myself, I think what is a much healthier goal is to try and execute the bakery, and then once the like the adrenaline of beginning has sort of settled down, and or whatever outcome it is or however it's going, the ideal goal then would be have it be another part of my work that's not as full-time as it is now, and I can reintroduce like other hobbies, and yeah, just find balance with a micro bakery business that by nature is very, at least in the infant stage, super demanding, at least with brain space.